Okay, let's move forward. In the last period we have studied about the properties of ionic compound. First we have studied about the physical nature. Ionic compounds are solid, ionic compounds are hard, ionic compounds are brittle and break into smaller pieces when pressure is applied. Melting and boiling points. Being solid, ionic compounds have high boiling point, high melting point. Number three, solubility. Ionic compounds are generally soluble in water and insoluble in kerosene and petrol, that we have studied into our last activity, my dear students. Conduction of electricity. Ionic compound in solid state do not conduct electricity, but either in their aqueous solution or in their molten state, they conduct electricity. Melting and boiling point of some of the ionic compound are written over here, my dear students, that for NaCl, the melting point is 1,074 Kelvin. The boiling point is 1,686 Kelvin. For lithium chloride, the melting point is 887 Kelvin, whereas the boiling point is 1,600 Kelvin. For calcium chloride, the melting point is 1,045 Kelvin, whereas the boiling point is 1,900 Kelvin. For calcium oxide, the melting point is 2,850 Kelvin, whereas the boiling point is 3,120 Kelvin. For magnesium chloride, the melting point is 981 Kelvin, whereas the boiling point is 1,685 Kelvin. My dear students, now we are going to study few of the very important scientific reason for these properties of ionic compound. Ionic compounds are solid and are somewhat hard. Now, why these ionic compounds are solid and they are somewhat hard? Ionic compounds have strong force of attraction between the positive and negative ion called electrostatic force of attraction.
Sir, aapki awaaz barabar nahi aa rahi.
Sir,
barabar sunai nahi de raha.
हाँ बेटा, हम ट्राई कर रहे हैं, आप सुनने का तो दिस आयनिक कंपाउंड्स हैव स्ट्रॉन्ग फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव आयन कॉल्ड द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन एंड दिस इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन मेक्स द आयनिक कंपाउंड which makes them solid and hard. The next reason that we can study, my dear students, is about ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points because, so these ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points because considerable amount of energy, is required to break the strong inter-ionic attraction between ions, so ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points. So this is the reason why the ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points. In solid state, my dear students, in solid state, ionic compounds do not conduct electricity. Now, ionic compounds do not conduct electricity in solid state, but they conduct electricity in either aqueous solution or in their molten state. So let us first understand. In solid state, ionic compounds do not conduct electricity. What is the reason why ionic compounds do not conduct electricity in solid state? To conduct the electricity, my dear students, either the free electron, either the free electrons or free ions are needed. In solid state, my dear students, in solid state, ionic compounds neither have free electrons nor have free ions. In solid state, my dear students, the ionic compounds neither have free electrons nor have free ions. So they do not conduct electricity in solid state.
Sir, आवाज
Dear students, a solution of ionic compound conducts the electricity. But the solid of the compound does not conduct electricity. This is what it happens because ionic compounds neither have free electrons nor have free ions. So they do not conduct electricity in solid state. A solution of ionic compound or molten ionic compound conducts electricity because in molten My dear students, we are trying to study that in molten state, the ionic compound conduct electricity. What is the reason behind it? In molten state, ions of ionic compound are free. In molten states, the ions of ionic compound are free. In aqueous solution, ions from ionic compounds are free because ionic compounds dissociate or ionizes in water to produce ions. Free ions are reversible for free ions are responsible for the conduction of electricity in ionic compounds. So this is how the ionic compounds conduct electricity, either in the molten state, because in molten state they have free ions, or they conduct electricity in their aqueous solution, because in aqueous solution they have free ions. Next question: how does the sodium chloride exist? My dear students, sodium chloride does not exist as a molecule, but aggregates of the oppositely charged ions. So sodium chloride exists as an aggregate of the oppositely charged ion. You can see here the figure that I have shown you, that these various ions, sodium plus ion, which are represented as a red dots, and Cl minus ion, which are represented as a green dots, they are present as if as they are the aggregate of oppositely charged ion, and they arrange themselves into the three dimension very properly, and this is how they exist. They are called the crystal litters. So ionic compounds are generally obtained in the form of the crystal litters. Then we have the next question. Show the formation of magnesium chloride, Na2O and MgO. Now this is the very important question from your in-text question and exercise. So first we should study about MgCl2, magnesium chloride. We know that in magnesium chloride, MgCl2, we have Mg, atomic number Z is equal to 12. So the electronic configuration is 282. So magnesium has got two dots or two electrons. Then we have magnesium has two valence electrons. To stabilize, it loses its two electrons and become like neon 2H, Z is equal to 10. So you can see magnesium 282 loses two electrons in the form of red dots, and it turns out to be magnesium plus 2, which is like neon. Then we have the next one to go. Then we think of chlorine, atomic number Z is equal to 17. So the electronic configuration is 287. In electronic configuration chlorine 287, you can see that chlorine has got 7 dots, and these 7 dots are representing the valence 7 electrons of chlorine. Now chlorine had 7 valence electrons. Chlorine for stabilizing itself accept electron from the magnesium. So this electron, which was donated by magnesium, each chlorine atom 287 accepts one electron and turns out to be Cl minus 2Na. But magnesium has donated two electrons, but magnesium gave two electrons. So two Cl atom 287 accept two electron, two dots of red, two red electron, and turn out to be 2Cl minus. The electronic configuration is 288, which is like argon, and this is how, where the Z or atomic number is 18, and this is how we get the chloride ion. Thus one magnesium plus 2 ion combines with the 2Cl minus ions with electrostatic force of attraction. You can see here, my dear students, that there are two chloride ions, Cl minus 1, Gl minus 1. Then we have Mg. These Mg and Cl have got electrostatic force of attraction for each other, and this is how MgCl2 is formed. Again, we can expect to have a crystal lattice of MgCl4, which is the aggregate of the oppositely charged ions. So 2Cl minus ions satisfy the plus